big game today. Liverpool vs Spurs. I'll take any win before we go. How long have we got until kickoff? Another half an hour before kickoff, everyone. Let me know your thoughts on the game anyway in the comment section below. I'm excited. It's a very big game. Spurs won midweek in the Champions League. We've got like, a huge threat. Harry Kane and Dele Alli and Winston are all playing today, along with Christian Eriksen as well. Joe Gomez misses out. Dejan Lovren, Joel Matip looks like he's still suffering with that knee injury anyway. We'll see how he fares against the England international Harry Kane. I think Kane looked at times today pinpoint Dejan Lovren in terms of one-on-one occasions, but everyone, I'm going to go for a 2-1. I'll take any win, even a 1-0 win today. It's huge 3 points. We know quality Spurs have got, and sorry, we've come out with this today with 3 points. It's huge, huge push to the end of the season, everyone. Fingers crossed. Come on, Edmund.
Get in, everyone. What a fantastic win that was for Liverpool. It was a bit of a mad game. Hummingson smashed Cannon crossbar. Everyone, I want to know your thoughts on the game. Who stood out for you in today's game anyway? Everyone, it's a huge, huge, huge 3 point. They had their chances, but I think Liverpool today, not from the start, we started off very slow, everyone. I think we can all agree on that. Very slow, lethargic, really. But we can look past that in terms of, we expected Tottenham Hotspur to really come out the blocks early. I didn't expect them to come out that early and get the goal anyway, but huge credit to Tottenham. Liverpool created a lot of chances. Tottenham's goalkeeper, I think was, I've forgotten his name anyway, but a great, great shot stopping, really. I think he's they're going to be their standout performer. The amount of chances we had, Bobby Firmino effort, and you're like, how is he keeping that out of the back of the net anyway, everyone? So huge credit to them. I think it would have been a lot more of a bigger scoreline if it wasn't for Tottenham Hotspur's goalkeeper. Credit to Dejan Lovren, Jordan Henderson as well. Obviously, Jürgen adopted with the a lot more defensive midfield. Really, I think we in the second half the players, I think Henderson kept on getting a lot more further forward up the pitch anyway, getting his goal. Great anticipation, really, to follow the shot in. And anyway, obviously, Mane, I haven't saw the replays anyway. Let me know your thoughts in terms of Mane's contact. Referee, straight over. I felt it was a pen, but I'll probably watch a match of the day tonight, really. But I think the referee's decision, we've had decisions like last week not go for us, and this week we've had decisions rightly go for us anyway. Tottenham Hotspur, the tension within the stadium, really. Everyone, don't know if he's picked up on it, if he's did go to the game or if you watched it wherever, let me know. Like, the way and the amount of times Tottenham Hotspur, like, even at 1-0, kept hold of the ball. The referee was not willing to give out yellow cards. He got a little bit better, especially in that second half anyway. He was dishing out the cards, but I tell you what, the standard of refereeing up and down this country is an absolute disgrace. The Premier League is such a multi-billion dollar brand, and you've got officiating like today, and obviously you had an Arsenal game as well, just coming to see what happened there. And frankly, Premier League has to go out and buy the best referees in Europe, really. It's got to a point, really. The VAR, are we using it, are we not? There's no communication throughout that whole game. There was no Tannoy announcements. You can't celebrate a goal properly. You're always like, yeah, get in, and then you're like, oh, what's VAR going to say? Is it going to be disallowed or not? It's frankly killing the game, really. Yeah, it might get the decisions right some weeks and wrong, but really, the FA and everyone, all the officials, need to really get their act together, because it's not just Liverpool fans, it's fans up and down the Premier League and League One, Championship and all that. Go and buy the world's best referees to complement the world's best league in the world, really. But everyone, that was a little rant on the referees anyway, but let me know your thoughts. Would you go out and buy the world's best referees anyway? I frankly would. I'd pay them whatever, as long as they're getting the officiating right. Really, standout performances for me today, everyone. Dejan Lovren, already mentioned his name. The shot Hummingson had, I think Dejan positions his body. I think it got a deflection off Lovren's foot and he flicked it onto the crossbar. Anyway, great, great. Especially when you've seen Joel Matip, the performance in which he's been putting in anyway. Dejan, frankly, he gets a lot of criticism, rightly or wrongly anyway. I've criticised him in the past, I will admit that. But tonight he was absolutely stonewall. He was positional, was great anyway. I think you can blame the whole team for very much the first goal. They were very... It's like they didn't know the ball had kicked off. Anyway, but it doesn't matter. We got 3 points. Three valuable points. Tottenham Hotspur. The amount of chances they had as well. They really didn't put it away. Harry Kane constantly in the referee's ear. Always throughout that game, everyone. But really, Trent and Robinson. Especially Robinson. Within that second half period, I felt the way in which he was getting forward down the left-hand side, he was picking and choosing rightly throughout that game. I felt him going down that left-hand flank very much opened the game for Liverpool. It allowed us really a lot more time and space. And Fabinho, really, from a defensive point of view, covered the spaces very good in that second half. When we were looking in that midfield, when it was a couple of times in the first half, when you're like, come on, pass the ball forward. It's not as simple as just saying pass the ball forward, because Spurs, from a defensive point of view, were very well set up today, really. I think they can be very disappointed the way in which they conceded their goals. But rightly, Liverpool's dogged display, we force every single last ball. Second balls were absolutely spot on. I think the first half, that's what we weren't really picking up on. But I think Jürgen giving them a kick up the backside really at half time and just told them to get out there and just win every single second ball. Because that's when you know within periods of a football game, when you do get those second balls, the early chances, we were first to the ball a lot of the times in the second half. And when we did get that goal, lovely bit of the dark arts, really. We were very calm, composed. We were doing what Spurs were doing when they were 1-0 down. Just take your time, easy as you like. Those 10 minutes at the back end of the game felt like forever, really, for me. Everyone, let me know your thoughts on that, really. But I'm more interested in what you've all had to say anyway. Get them involved in the comment section below and I will read them all out in tomorrow's episodes, everyone. The end of the season, we'll see how big these 3 points are. But in terms of a opposition, Tottenham Hotspur, along with Manchester City, I think they would have posed, and they would have posed, the biggest threats that we will face at Anfield. But to come out of this game, 3 points, huge, huge 3 points as a start off the show. But everyone, have a quasi rest of your Sunday night. And the Reds have got all 3 points. Get in. Everyone, I will see you tomorrow for another episode. And as always, Reds, you never walk alone. Try and enjoy your Monday before I'm hiccuping. Always get it at the wrong time anyway, hiccups. But yeah, see you later, everyone, tomorrow. And come on, Red Men.